These are the plaintiffs, Jason Strauss and Christy Burks Strauss. Christy says she and her husband hired the defendant to clean their brown couch. After the defendant was done, however, their brown couch was now pink. The inept defendant ruined their property. And if that weren't bad enough, he also stole from them. They're suing for $3,669.90, the money they're owed. This is the defendant, David Blake. He says there was some sort of chemical reaction, and the plaintiff's couch did indeed turn pink. He took the couch to try to figure out what went wrong, and next thing he knows, he's being sued for stealing. Bottom line, he offered to repair the plaintiff's couch. He refunded the money he paid them to clean the couch, and he owes nothing. He's accused of couching the issue. The defendant has filed a countersuit for $2,201.80 for loss of business plus storage.
All parties, please raise your right hand. You see it, come to order, please. Litigants have been sworn, Your Honor.
Thank you, Douglas. Jason Strauss and Christy Burks Strauss. Yes. You are suing David Blake and Freedom DLB Incorporated. That's your company?
Yes, ma'am.
For $3,669.90 to replace a couch, refund services, plus attorney's fees, because according to you, he ruined your couch. You're counterclaiming loss of business and storage for the couch. Okay, let's hear from you first.
So on February 7th, we had hired Mr. Blake's company, Freedom Clean, to come out and to clean four area rugs and two matching sofa sets at our home. And his attendants, the technicians came out, they treated the rugs and the couch, and when they were getting ready to leave, the couches seemed, they're like a light tan color, and they seemed really wet. And when I said something to them, they had like this striping on them, and they normally don't have the striping. He said, as they dry, the stripes will go away. It's just from the material.
Who did you talk to? Who'd you have that conversation with?
This was one of the technicians.
But did you see the technician here?
Yes.
Were you the person who took care of that? Can you stand up right there? Okay, go ahead.
And so he was there, and so I was like, that's fine. My husband came home, and when he came home, I was actually in the other room, and I hadn't been back in there. We had just had a baby. And he said, did you see the couches? And as the couches started to dry, they no longer, one couch, like the stripes went away, and it was dry in a normal color. The couches are kind of an L-shaped form.
Are they the same couches? Like from the same manufacturer, you bought them together, they're a set?
Yes, a set. And so when the other couch was drying, it started to turn a red and pink color. So I have a picture of it. This is kind of the discoloration that came up. My husband immediately called the company that same day. Mr. Blake then said, I'll send someone right out. The same technician came out the next day. And when they saw the couches, he looked at it. He tried to like rub it. And they agreed that the one couch was permanently discolored. And at that time then, my husband spoke again to Mr. Blake, and Mr. Blake said...
Okay, hold on. First of all, she has described a conversation between the two of you where she says that one of the couches was really wet and the striping, and that you had said that'll go away when it dries. Is that accurate? Did that conversation take place?
Yeah.
So now you were describing a conversation that your husband had. Let me hear it from your husband. Go ahead.
Okay, so I spoke to Mr. Blake after his technician said, yes, the couch is ruined. He said, you know, don't worry about it. We have...
Mr. Blake did or the technician?
Mr. Blake.
Okay.
I got on the phone with
and
him.
And this is telephonically?
It is.
Mm-hmm.
It is. And he said, you know, I'm insured. You know, we'll make this right somehow, some way. We'll either credit all the services, make up the difference in the price of the couch in cash, or put a claim on my insurance.
Wrong.
Okay.
Well, he wanted to come out and see the couch himself, so we came out 2 days later and said, yes, you know, this is destroyed, so let me figure out a way to make this right.
Okay, and then what happens?
A few days went by, and he said, well, you know, well, what are you gonna do with the couch? And I said, well, we can't keep it in the house anymore, so I said, we're gonna go ahead and give it to somebody. And he said, well, if I'm gonna pay for the couch one way or the other, let me at least have it.
Hold on, no, this is not an audience participation sport. When it's your turn, I won't let him yell wrong either. Okay, go.
So that is what happened. So he said, we'll make it right one way or the other. And then he said he wanted to come get the couch. I said, well, you're not going to get the couch until you give us payment of some sort or compensate us for the damaged couch.
Is that what you said? Or did you say, well, yeah, you're buying the couch, so come get the couch?
Well, yes, I did, but he never brought the money.
Right.
So he called me one day, he said, I have a trailer, I'm on the way to the house. I'm like, you haven't compensated us for the couch, you're not getting the couch until that happens.
Is that what you said?
Yes.
Or is it, wait for me, I'm on my way?
No, I was not on my way.
Okay. I'm sorry, because that's what you said, right?
No. So what happened was, you know, when the whole conversation came up, my husband was trying to be, he's like, look, if you want to file an insurance claim, whatever it is. But he said, no, I want to pay the difference and I'll pick up the couch. When he contacted my husband, it was under the assumption he was coming to get the couch and give him the difference. And we had also understood that he would already like charge back.
How did he get the couch?
We had moved it into like a single car garage.
And how did he get access to the garage?
It was up because we had painters in our house. So they were coming in and out. We were in the process of moving.
So when he called and said, I'm on my way with a truck to pick up the couch, according to you, you say what?
I said, you're not getting the couch unless we receive compensation, period. End of conversation. He said,
Well, no. Who was going to collect the money if neither of you are home?
Well, he didn't have the money, so I wasn't.
Well, you don't
come
know
home.
That because you haven't asked him if you have the money. Why are you taking the couch?
For evidence, ma'am.
Oh, what have you done with it since then, since you have this
it
priceless evidence?
It is sitting
evidence
in storage.
Why is it sitting in storage?
I don't have any place to put it.
No, hold on. Hold on. You took the couch for evidence.
Correct.
Meaning what? What were you going to do with it?
I was going to contact the manufacturer or the place to.
So what did the manufacturer say when you contacted
them? I did not get to that far because.
And so you've had the couch for how long?
Mr. Strauss got really squirrely, and I cut off all conversation and handed him my insurance paperwork.
Yeah, but he doesn't want to have to make a claim. He wants you to make a claim. They want you to make good on what they said you said you'd do, which is refund the cost of services, that's $769.90, and then replace the couch minus the $769.90. In other words, put them in the position they would have been in had you cleaned the couches and not ruined them. How old are the couches?
We got them in July of 2016.
Right, so they were relatively new. And this occurred when? February of this year.
This is February
7th. So they're still available and everything else. Do you have a receipt for the couch?
I do.
And I also have. Never once did I tell them I would pay them cash.
Well, I don't understand though. What do you say you did tell them?
I told them.
They call you for, hold on, let's start from the beginning. They call you, he goes back and you know they're ruined, right?
Yes.
Okay, and why are you saying no? He says yes, he's the guy who ruined it, and he's admitting that he ruined it. He's honest. Okay, so then you speak to him, and what is it you do tell the homeowner?
I need to see him.
Okay, so then you go and you see him, and then what's your conclusion when you see it?
I told him, yes, they are damaged.
Okay.
The one is, he says they were dyed, where they were not dyed, they were bleached.
I don't know what that means, that you bleached them?
They turned, no.
What do you mean?
They turned red when carpet or furniture turns red like that.
One of them turned red.
Exactly, one of them. When carpet or furniture turns red like that, it is a bleaching agent that has been put on them.
Okay.
We don't have bleaching agents on our vehicles. So whatever he put on that sofa before we got there.
Well, they don't put bleaching agent on their sofa.
They probably more than likely tried to clean them themselves and failed and called in a professional.
Stop. Did you see any evidence of bleaching of a sofa? Because I gotta tell you, I've lived a long time and I've done a lot of stupid things in my life. But the one thing I have yet to do is take bleach to a sofa that's a month old.
I didn't say bleach per se. It's a bleaching agent they used.
Like
there's
what?
Many bleach. Hydrogen peroxide.
Name one.
Hydrogen peroxide.
Or take hydrogen peroxide to a sofa that's a few months old. Neither one of those would I do. And we know they don't do it because they hired you. Okay, and the thing is only 7 months old, so we know what they do. After 7 months, they hire you guys. All right, what do you think happened?
I believe something was on the sofa that when I extracted, hot water extracted, it pulled possibly a dye out or it bleached whatever product that they applied to.
So what is it you guys use?
We use green products, citrus, melon.
Do you ever test a small area to see what's going to happen?
Yes, I do. I always start in the back first.
And when you did that, was there any evidence of the redness?
No.
So how long does it take for the red to come out?
It could come out immediately. It could take a couple minutes.
Okay, and how long, put your hand down, please, and how much later did you notice the red?
Within 3 hours.
A few hours, yeah.
Yeah.
So apparently it can come out in 3 hours.
It could.
How often does this happen?
Never.
No, that's not never.
Okay, one time.
Welcome back to the People's Court. Harvey Levin here. So is it automatically the fault of the guy who cleans the couch if it goes from brown to pink?
Yes, it is.
Why? Why?
because when he started cleaning it was brown. When he finished, it was pink. I don't care if it's a different material.
Well, what if the material does make a change?
He should know better. That's his profession, yeah. so he should know.
If you're a professional couch cleaner, you should know what to use
in
that
sample.
Yeah, and yeah.
God, people got all worked up over a stinking sofa here going inside the courtroom.
I don't quite get what your position is, though, because there and you see that it's ruined, and then you take the couch and then did nothing to solve the problem.
It's not that I did nothing. He became so demanding and unreasonable.
Why?
What
was he demanding?
I divorced myself from the situation and told him
demanding?
To hire an attorney.
A refund.
Demanding money.
Well, yeah, because the couch
refund.
Is ruined.
He was demanding a cash refund, demanding a payment for the price,
$29.99. That's the same as the cash refund. All of that is the same as, you ruined my couch, fix it.
I did not ruin his couch. We did not ruin his couch. It is my position that he applied something on that sofa before we got there.
You have zero evidence of that. Did you apply a bleaching agent to your couch?
No.
What did you do to clean your couch? Hire them?
Yeah.
Okay, done. Now, you took their couch, you didn't refund their money, you didn't refund the cost of the couch. So, exactly what's... Ow, wait! No, wait, it gets better. Hold on. Please stop.
Okay. Awesome.
You're suing for lost business because...
Simply the accusation of technicians stealing items out of people's houses can be very detrimental to my business.
And has it been?
How do we know?
Exactly. So if you don't know, I don't know, and I can't put a figure on it. That's because you guys called the police when you realized the couch was missing.
Well, we asked, yes, exactly.
And the same day?
No, we tried to first work it out with him. We're like, return the couch. And then he told us to file a claim with his insurance company. We were still being reasonable. And we said, fine. When we contacted the insurance company, they had already denied it. I have a letter from the insurance company, and it states that the insured was hired to clean your couches, in the course of doing so, damaged and discolored them. We are writing to advise you that we have denied coverage to our insured in this matter.
Oh, wow, you need to get better insurance. All right, hand that over.
I'm sorry.
And then storage. You're suing for storage of the couch that you took, according to them, without their authority.
Yes, ma'am. They will not come back and get it. I can't take it to them because they moved. I don't know where to take it to. I'll bring it to you. You can have it.
No. Are you out of your mind? Are you living on the planet Earth with the rest of us? Because anyone listening to you is a little shocked that you have the unmitigated gall not only to take the couch, which that I understand. You take the couch because you want to deal with the manufacturer. I get that. That's fine. But then you don't refund the price of cleaning. You don't make good on it. You tell them, go after my insurance. Your insurance denies it because they say you ruined it. They have to sue you for you to make good, and then you sue them for storage. For real?
Absolutely.
I could listen to you all day long.
Awesome.
It is just a pleasure. There's nothing to me that's more fun than watching someone take advantage of someone else and making it right. That's why I do this. That's why I do it. Okay, folks. So my verdict is for the plaintiff in this case. On your countersuit against them, zero. On your claim against him, $2,099, plus whatever sales tax you would be out as well, plus your court costs. And attorney's fees of $800. Who's your attorney?
I am my
husband. Okay, all right. So no attorney's fees, and what will make you whole is a $2,099, plus, of course, sales tax on that, plus your court costs. That's my judgment for the plaintiff. On your counterclaim, zero.
Well, the plaintiff prevails. She gets $2,099 plus some assorted extra costs. Mr. Blake, you made the judge's day today. This was not a good day for you in court. Would you agree?
It was a great day. The judge did not understand the full implications of the case.
What didn't she understand?
Every story the plaintiffs told was a lie.
The point is, you didn't do anything you
said
you were
going
to do.
And I was willing from day... I didn't say that. They said I said it. I did not say that. I've always been willing to refund them the price of the cleaning of the sofa.
You didn't do it, though.
I'm glad.
You ruined it.
Because I had to come to court.
I can't go over the whole case with you, but how about that? Mr. Blake, you're a winner. Boy, you pick them good, don't you?
I know.
How did you buy Get him there.
Well, you know what? Actually, someone else that works with me found them and suggested them, and we're going to have a long talk with her. Yeah.
No kidding. You got to. I'm sorry you couldn't get your attorney fees back.
Oh, I know.
I thought that was kind of cute. But
well,
anyway, you'll get a new couch out of this.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Fair enough.
Fair
you satisfied?
Enough.
He said you acted squirrely. Well, I didn't get to ask him what he meant by that.
I didn't get to ask him. He's crazy.
I think most people might agree with you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Congratulations.
Right.
Okay,
you.
We appreciate it. Harvey, what do you think?
Doug, I got to say, this is really the situation where it is appropriate to write a bad review on Facebook. That will do it for this case. Litigants for the next case on the way into the courtroom right now.